morning and everybody, welcome back to Primary Robins Online. I'm Rosie, still, and I hope you're all doing really well and having a great time back at online virtual school, which is very exciting, probably a bit weird, but hopefully you guys are all enjoying it. So, we're back, as always, we've got lots to do. So we started last week, we started a new piece from Joseph and his Technicolor Dreamcoat, called Any Dream Will Do. Well, this week we're going to try really hard and try and finish that song, so then we'll have two songs under our belts. So we got to get going. As always, lots to do, lots to go. Let's get started. So come into a nice tall sitting position for me, feeling really nice, long and serene and beautiful. Good job. I'm going to start by rolling our shoulders. Our shoulders are so important because they're attached to so much of us that we're about to use. We've got our neck muscles there, of course our voice in the middle of our neck, and then coming down to your tummies, behind which a little bit further up, of course your lungs. So your shoulders are actually really maybe more important than we think, so let's give them a nice warm up. What we're going to do, we're starting by rolling them in circles. So come forward, up, squeeze them in, and then back, and all the way down. Good, let's do it again. Forward, squeeze them up, back, and down. One last time. Forward, squeeze up, back, down. Beautiful. Let's change direction. Ready? Back, up, forward, down, back, up, forward, and down. One last time. Back, forward, up, and drop them down. Great, give yourselves a wiggle out. Oh, gets rid of all those nasty aches and pains you might have. Lovely job. Come to your nose, draw a couple of circles for me. So we're going one way with your nose, and then back the other way. Good job, makes me go a little bit cross-eyed, maybe a little bit dizzy. Ooh. Fab! All right, so we've warmed up here. We've given our neck muscles a nice little swivel. Let's start moving downwards to our lungs. So take two fingers like this for me. Good job. And what we're going to do, we're going to tuck them just in that little bit where your rib cage comes up and down like a pair of curtains. And the way we know that we're in the right place, people who've heard this before will know, is if we go shh, like you're telling someone to be quiet really loudly, you'll feel a little kick under your fingers. So try that for me. Ready? Did you feel it? If not, doesn't matter. You can pause me and just fiddle around until you find that special place that kicks under your fingers. For those of us who have found it, when you've done that, come back and join us. Let's do three in a row. Ready? And good job. Now three short, sharp hisses. Ready? Very nice. So, as I'm certain most of you, because I'm sure I've said this before, will know, what's that kicking under your fingers? It's the diaphragm, that massive great muscle underneath your lungs, holding them together, shaped a little bit like an upside down trampoline. And all that does is it controls our breathing. So it's really important. No diaphragm, no breathing, not good. So we've got to take care of it. That means warm it up. Okay, so what we're going to do that is we're going to blow out some imaginary birthday candles. We've got five of them here. Your fingers are going to pretend to be them. Five short, sharp puffs of air to blow out five imaginary birthday candles. Ready? Here we go. And brilliant. Nice and easy, right? Let's make it harder. 10. Here we go. In and lovely job. Make it 15. Means you've got to use one hand twice. Here we are. And it's hard work, isn't it? It makes you go all tingly in the lips. We're going to do one more. We're going to go for 20, which means we do each hand twice. It's a lot to get through, so make sure you're sitting up nice and straight. Give your lungs the best possible chance. Here we go. And Did you make it? I did, but I'm a bit tired in the tummy now. So, well done. That's really warmed up that big, important muscle. And through that, we've given the lungs a bit of a clear out as well. So we've done shoulders, all the muscles. We've done the breathing muscles. I think it's time to get into warming up the voice. So what we're going to do, most of you will know this game already, is cat falling off a log, which makes this noise. It's meow. Get that? Ready? Meow. Let's do it one more time. Meow. And slow motion goes meow. So flipping that on its head, a cat jumping onto a log makes this noise. Meow. You try. Meow. Another one. Meow. One more for luck. Meow. And in slow motion, meow. Good job. All right, imagine you are chewing the world's stickiest toffee and it's getting all really stuck around your teeth. Gotta work really hard to unstick it. You can't use your hands. Good job. Spit into your hand. Stick it on the ceiling. Gross. All right, lovely. So now we imagine that we've just smelt the most amazing smell, maybe of your favourite dinner cooking. And we go, We start up low, go up high, come back again. Try it again with me. This time it's so good. We're going to go really high. Ready? Good job. Lovely. All right, we're so nearly there, ready to start singing. We're going to play one game first. This is the 1-1-2-1 game. So, what happens when we build music up in steps? We're building what we call a scale. It's where the music moves up and then down. And in this game, we're going to give every step a number. So we're going to start with step one. One. Then we add on step two. One, two, one. Step three. One, two, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. And that's it. We only go up to eight because there's only eight steps in a scale. It's a bit funny, isn't it? You think there'd be 10, but no, we've only got eight. So what we do, we always start at one and we always come back to one. But we always add on a step every time. Let's try it all the way through. Here we go. And one, one, two, one, one, two, three, two, one, one, two, three, four, three, two, one, one, two, three, four, five, four, three, two, one, one, two, three, four, five, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Did you manage it? Well done. If so, if you didn't, doesn't matter. We'll be doing this a bit more. So we're going to do it a little bit faster. Hold on to your horses. Get a good seat. Make sure you're comfortable sitting up nice and straight. Let's have a go. Ready? Here we go. One, one, two, one. One, two, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. And take a big deep breath. Well done, everybody. That's hard. So we're going to make it harder. All right. What we're going to do is we're going to take out the number three. We're going to get rid of it. Three for us does not exist anymore. Instead, what we're going to do is when we should say three, we're going to clap instead. Let me demonstrate. One, one, two, one, one, two, two, one, one, two, four, two, one, one, two, four, five, four, two, one. Do you see what I'm saying there? Every time we should say three, we clap instead. That means that number four is actually the hardest, because if you think about it, you go one, two, three, four, three. It comes really fast around. So watch out for that one. Let's try it. Ready? Get yourself comfortable. Here we go. One, one, two, one, one, two, two, one, one, two, four, two, one, two, four, five, four, two, one, one, two, four, five, six, five, four, two, one, one, two, four, five, six, seven, six, five, four, two, one, one, two, four, five, six, seven, eight, seven, six, five, four, two, one. Did you get it? It's really tough. So if you didn't, it literally doesn't matter. There's always the option to pause, rewind, go back and try again. Or if you think, nah, let's just get on with some singing, we can do that too. So last week, we sort of refreshed, revised, relearned supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. So we're going to start off with that. See if we can remember it all. Get yourselves ready. Sit now nice and straight. Here we go. I love that song, really. I think it's brilliant. And you are doing such a great job. I can hear through the airwaves. All right, brilliant. So that's got us in the mood, got us moving around, got us singing. Let's now move to the song we started last week, which was Any Dream Will Do from Joseph and his amazing Technicolor dream coat. Remember the story of Joseph, a man who had the amazing ability to dream about the future, to know what was going to happen through his dreams. And in this song, he sings about it. We learned the first two little bits. Last week, I closed my eyes, drew back the curtain to see for certain what I thought I knew. And in the far, far away, that's my fault, getting the words wrong, far, far away, someone was weeping, but the world was sleeping. Any dream will do. So that's the bit we learned last week. Let's see how much we can remember. Ready? How did you do? Did you remember it all? If you didn't, doesn't matter. We'll be doing some more of it. So, now that we've gone through that, we've refreshed our memories, let's get going. Let's see if we can learn the rest of the song. The next bit. I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colours shining, wonderful and new. That sounds brilliant. I think I want a coat like that. So, I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colours shining, wonderful and new. Now the good news is that this is the same tune as the first bit. You ready? I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colours shining, wonderful and new. Let's try all of that together. Ready? I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colours shining, wonderful and new. Next little bit. And in the east, the dawn was breaking and the world was waking. Any dream will do. Remember that last line is the same as it is in the first half, isn't it? We've already had that line, so that's a nice one to remember. So, and in the east where the sun rises, the dawn was breaking, the sun was coming up, and the world was waking. Any dream will do. It's the same tune. So let's sing it together, see if we can. Ready? And in the lovely. Let's put that together with some hands. Ready? And in the east, the dawn was breaking, and the world was waking. Any dream will do. That chord tells you something new's happening. Brilliant. Good job so far. So we've now got to a new bit. A crash of drums, a flash of light. My golden coat flew out of sight. The colours faded into darkness. I was left alone. So we sometimes talk about words that sound like what they are, what they're describing. It's a word, long word, onomatopoeia. You might have heard it before. And we've got some here. A crash of drums. The word crash sounds like a crash, doesn't it? So let's make loads of those words when they come up. I'm going to sing you a line, you sing it back. A crash of drums, a flash of light. Your turn, ready? A crash of drums, a flash of light. Would help if I didn't play the wrong note on the piano. But are you sure you did well regardless? Next bit goes like this. My golden coat flew out of sight. You try with me. My golden coat flew out of sight. Ready? Let's try that bit together. A crash of drums, a flash of light. My golden coat flew out of sight. Beautiful. Next bit goes like this. The colours faded into darkness. I was left alone. You try with me. High, so make sure we're sitting up nice and straight to give our lungs a chance. The colours faded into darkness. I was left alone. And alone is a long note, so make sure you've got enough air. Good job. All right, let's go from a crash of drums, a flash of light. One, two, three, four. A crash of drums, a flash of light. My golden coat flew out of sight. The colours faded into darkness. I was left alone. Sounds crashy, doesn't it? I love that bit. We're really near the end. We're so nearly there. Next bit, the words. May I return to the beginning. The light is dimming and the dream is too. The world and I, we are still waiting, still hesitating. Any dream will do. I'm going to split that into half. Sing it once, we'll sing it together. Next half, sing it once, we'll sing it together. We'll stitch the whole thing. Ready? May I return to the beginning. The light is dimming and the dream is too. Let's try that. Ready? May I return to the beginning. The light is dimming and the dream is too. Good job. Last bit. The world and I, we are still waiting, still do that last line twice because it's the end. Let's try all that together. Ready? The world and I, we are still waiting. The world and I, we are still waiting, still hesitating. Any dream will do. Any dream. Brilliant. Good job. What we're going to do, we're going to put all of that together, those two halves. We'll sing the whole song through. And then that's the end of this session. Next week, we'll put some fancy bits to this. Ready? So first of all, just the last section. May I return to the done you. Right the way back to the beginning, whole song through, another week of Primary Robins. Tick. Ready? Get yourselves comfy, sit up straight, here we go. Thank you. Brilliant. Thanks so much for joining me again, everybody. I'm really looking forward to next week, where we will put some sparkly fancy bits on this piece and maybe, hopefully, start a new one. See you next time. Bye!